Senator Grace Poe may have claimed solo lead in the latest Pulse Asia survey that also saw Vice President Jejomar Binay dropping to third place and tied with former Secretary Mar Rojas, while Davao City Mayor Rodrigo Duterte held on to the second spot. The survey was commissioned by ABS-CBN. It was conducted from March 1 to 6, covering 2,600 registered voters with a margin of error of plus minus 1.9%. The survey was completed 2 days before the Supreme Court paved the way for Poe's candidacy. It also came after the second largest political party in the country had endorsed her for president. Based on the data, it's still essentially a four-way race with no clear frontrunner less than 2 months before the elections.
The fact that the Senator Poe cleared the error margin, just went a little over the error margin, it really says it's still a very tight race.
But two candidates appear to have been consolidating votes in their political strongholds, Rojas in the Visayas and Duterte in Mindanao. Duterte supporter Lito Banayo says it's an important campaign strategy, especially in a tight race.
If you have solid enough support behind you, then you can start trying to win more of the votes of the others.
Outside your own stronghold.
Rojas was the front runner in all four regions in the Visayas. He shared the top spot with Duterte in Central Visayas, or vote-rich Cebu, which has 2.7 million registered voters. Duterte was either number one or shared the lead with another candidate in six regions in Mindanao. Metro Manila remains a major battleground for the four presidential contenders, given its 6.2 million registered voters. Poe was the top choice of 30% of voters, while Duterte and Binay each had 23%. Rojas had 13%. In the vice presidential race, Poe's running mate, Senator Francis Escudero, was still in a statistical tie with Senator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. for first place. Escudero, who was also endorsed by the NPC, had 25%, while Marcos had 22%. Behind them was Rojas' running mate, Congresswoman Leni Robredo, who had 21%. In the senatorial race, two administration candidates are vying for the 12th and final slot, former TESA Director Joel Villanueva and Senator T.G. Gingona. Also in contention was Valenzuela Congressman Sherwin Gatchalian, who is part of Poe's senatorial ticket. 14 candidates have a statistical chance of making it to the Magic 12. All but former Justice Secretary Laila De Lima are either former or incumbent legislators. Christian Isguera, ABS-CBN News.